knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
We just finished the biological anthropology portion of this series, which means that we have discussed the evolution of Homo sapiens as a species. To get from the birth of modern humans to where we are today as a technologically advanced society, we must now pivot to the field of archaeology. Archaeology is the study of humans through examining their material remains. These material remains range from the elaborate tombs of pharaohs to a piece of garbage from a Victorian-era farmstead. Using the scientific method, archaeologists are able to examine material remains to discover more about the culture, life, and death of those who left them. Material remains that are over 50 years old are called artifacts or features. Artifacts refer to movable objects, like an axe or a pot, whereas features refer to immovable objects, like a wall or fire pit. Most archaeologists study artifacts and features, as material remains under 50 years old are studied by cultural anthropologists, the third discipline that will be discussed in this anthropology series. A place where many artifacts and features can be found and studied is called a site. A site in archaeology has definable limits and is usually defined by a specific culture or people's use. Homesteads, villages, and cities are common examples of archaeological sites, but this can also include campsites, religious sites, animal kill sites, and material extraction areas. Archaeology is an interdisciplinary field. A basic understanding of geology is critical to artifact dating and excavation. An understanding of biology is important as well, especially for archaeologists who focus on human or animal remains. Another crucial field for archaeologists is history. Being familiar with the written record of a region is important for an archaeologist to generate hypotheses about those people. Many archaeologists specialize in an area of the discipline, using their expertise from another field. A zoo archaeologist is an archaeologist who studies animals associated with people, such as identifying which animals were hunted or reared by a group of people. Geoarchaeologists use more in-depth geological methods to study material remains, such as using coring to discern the geological history of a cave where Neanderthal tools were found. Historic archaeologists are those who study historical peoples or events, such as American Civil War battlefields or English factories from the 19th century. Many other specializations exist in archaeology, covering most sciences and topics in human history. Archaeology as a science began in the late 18th century, differentiating itself from antiquarianism. Antiquarianism has been popular since the Renaissance and involves the collecting of artifacts to display in wealthy collectors' homes, rather than to learn anything about the people who made them. These people often did not care about the destruction of archaeological sites, even using dynamite to get deeper into sites or burial chambers, and they recorded very little. However, by the late 1700s, the scientific method was being adopted by more people and utilized by more and more disciplines. A few wealthy collectors educated in scientific methodology began excavating ancient ruins not just to add items to their collection, but to learn about the people who made them. These important pioneers include Johann Winckelmann in classical archaeology of Greece and Rome, Thomas Jefferson in American archaeology, and Jean-Francois Champollion in Egyptology. These people and their colleagues were some of the first to make hypotheses about human history using the material remains they uncovered. It's important to note that, like in many other sciences, these early hypotheses were often proved wrong as the discipline matured and new data was found. For example, early American archaeologists thought the wealth of artifacts in North America made with high precision couldn't have been made by the native peoples, and developed hypotheses rooted in racism, such as immigrants from Europe making them in prehistory and dying out. We know today that these incredible artifacts were made by the ancestors of indigenous Americans. These changes in how archaeology is performed and viewed are reflected in the development of archaeological theory. Many movies, such as Indiana Jones or The Mummy, paint archaeologists as antiquarian adventurers rather than scientists. This has led to some confusion in the general public as to how archaeologists are able to speak with authority on information such as when and how the beginnings of civilizations occurred, or recount the rise and fall of kingdoms in a region that left no written records. This series will show how archaeologists can know these things. To do this, we will cover the basics of archaeological theory and methodology before looking at any specific archaeological site or culture. These sections will also provide insight as to how we found and excavated many of the hominid remains discussed earlier in the series. So if all that sounds exciting to you, let's learn some archaeology.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.